Welcome to the class of Editorial Decode, and in this class I will be decoding the sprouting of the look west policy written by Sanjay Bharu. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is very, very important for political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how we are trying to explore the uncharted territories in the domain of diplomacy. This editorial is also about how the relationship between the Middle East countries and the India could create a synergetic relationship, and how this synergism could lead to the unleashment of the new in the world of diplomacy. This editorial is also about how the weakening of the Western world, how the fragility of the Western world has forced the Middle East countries to look out for new partners, and the new partners in the form of China, India and the countries of the Far East from them. Now, in order to properly understand this editorial, we need to know about how India has been trying to explore new areas in the realm of diplomacy. We have tried, till now we have tried relationship with Russia, ex-USSR. We have tried relationship with Western countries. We have tried relationship with China. We have tried relationship with Eastern countries, the Indonesia, Myanmar, Thailand and Laos, Cambodia and Vietnam. We have already tried the relationship with these countries, but of late what we have been trying to do, we have been trying to forge a relationship with the Muslim world, the Middle East countries. Now why India has been of late trying to forge up a relationship with these countries? What is the reason behind it? Now, the world till now has seen a lot of conflict between Christianity, the Christian world and the Muslim world. Though the Christianity and the Muslims are the cousin religions, but the conflict, the attrition and the antagonism between these worlds has led to the creation of a new situation, engendering of a new situation. And this new situation has provided a lot of leeway and freedom to India to explore this uncharted territory of the Middle East countries. Now the new situation that has unfolded, there is a lot of promise in the synergism between both the countries, that is India and the Middle East countries. Now this entire region of Middle East, it is full of the energy resources. It is brimming up with energy resources. And as far as India is concerned, we don't have shale gas. And we are in the need of the energy resources. Now the old importers of the energy, that is United States of America and the other European countries, they are trying to explore new form of energy. They actually want self-sufficiency in the energy resources. Now India is not self-sufficient in the energy resources. We are just trying to be self-reliant in the domain of the energy resources. So this aspect has created a lot of potential to forge up this relationship. Now the Christian world, it has created a lot of troubles in the Muslim world. Now the Christian world in the past, it had tried to dominate, it had tried to hegemonize, it had tried to impose the Western vision onto the Muslim world. Now, it is just like you're trying to impose the fundamentalism of democracy over the fundamentalism of the Islamic world. So this fundamentalism, it has led to the repulsion between the two countries, between the two worlds, the Christian world and the Muslim world. But on the contrary, if you take the case of India, India is a soft country. Till now we have projected ourselves as a soft power. In the 65 years since independence, we have developed this resource of intangibility. This intangibility means we are accommodative. We are responsible. We are mature. We are rational. We have provided to the world a vision. We have provided to the world the standards of how a country can uphold its image high by associating it with the top standards of morality. We have not done away with our moral principles. Now this is something intangible that is helping India to reap the benefits of the tangibles. But this intangibility is not available to the Western world. And because of that, India is looking towards West. And the way India is trying to forge up a relationship with the Muslim world, it will also help India to resolve its conflict with Pakistan. Because for the moment, Pakistan is having a lot of support of the Muslim world. The countries like Yemen, Oman, UAE, Saudi Arabia, now all these countries, they are backing Pakistan on the issue of Kashmir. But if India will forge up its economic relationship with the Middle East countries, it will help India to solve the intricate problem of Kashmir. Now, another thing that is very, very important is that with respect to choosing up of a partner, with respect to choosing up its futuristic course, with which country the Middle East world would like to move? Will it be the China or will it be the India? Now, if you look at the character of China as a country, it is similar to that of United States of America. Now, both these countries, they are hard countries. Both these countries, they have a dream to be world power. World power in terms of military. World power in terms of implicitly trying to imperialize the world. But on the contrary, India is a country which do not harbor such a dream. The dream of India is a dream of a universal world. Dream of India is a dream of the egalitarian country. And this is something that is reflected. This is a piousness. This is a sacredness that is reflected in the constitution and in the preamble of our country. And this is something that the author of this editorial has mentioned at the end. It is the spirit and the conscience of our constitution that has helped India to explore everything. We have explored the communist world. We have explored the capitalist world. We are on the verge to exploring the Middle East countries. We have explored South America. We have explored Africa. So India is a country which is having a lot of credibility. We might not be having the technology at par of United States of America. We might not be a developed country like United States of America. But this softness that India is having, it is a huge resource. It is a big resource. And it holds a lot of potential in the days to come. And it is because of this softness that the entire world is behind India for getting it a permanent seat in United Nations. It is because of this softness India is playing up an important role in WTO. It is because of this softness India has been made party to the world, regional and global organizations. So India needs to act more responsibly so that we can reap more and more out of this softness. Like we are on the verge of exploiting and exploring and discovering from the Middle East countries. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes and entire civil services preparation. And to avail the further information about the classes that we are offering, please visit our websites, that is eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.